I know it will be a very interesting and engaging webinar, unlike some where you only listen. Here you are to participate actively, I guess. And of course, it is a great privilege to welcome Professor Bashab Chaudhary, sir, Vice Chancellor of West Bengal State University, as our chief guest. And sir, your indefatigable and tireless spirit, your presence, your dynamic presence, I would say, is always a source of inspiration for us. And we love to have you, sir, for ever encouraging us in all the activities that our college organizes. It's a pleasure to have you with us, sir.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Nisha.
Thank you, sir. And I would also like to welcome. Yes.
1 or 2 minutes for madam. Huh? 1 or 2 minutes. She is joining. Okay.
Okay. So in the meantime, I would like to welcome the speaker of the day, Dr. Shubhadeep Chakraborty, postdoctoral scientist, International Center for Theoretical Sciences, Bangalore. It's a pleasure to have you with us, sir, and hope you find the entire workshop, if I may call it that,
very productive.
Yes, I'm sorry. Was there somebody who wanted to make an observation?
Okay. I guess Monisha, you can continue. Sorry for the interruption.
Okay, no problem. I mean, since we are on this virtual platform, I guess we need to get used to the new normal and these voices which come from nowhere. Before Madam steps in, I think Dr. Panchali Mojumdar is there with us, IQSE coordinator of East Calcutta Girls College. I mean, it goes without saying that she let me continue. It goes without saying that her dedication, her efficiency, her sincerity regarding her efforts to enhance the quality of all the activities which are going on in our college is laudable, and we really appreciate that.
Yes,
thank you, madam, for being with us.
Yes, madam is joining, sir. Throughout this webinar, there is one problem always. Somehow we have sometimes some network problems, and madam is joining right now. I have given him her code and all these passwords, and she is joining right now. She will join. And sir, here we have the participants. One thing I want to mention you, sir, that here all the participants are of different types. They are from faculties, they are from research scholars, and overall they are the students of our institution. There are some postgraduate and undergraduate students of our institutions, and they have no registration fees. They will learn this from this webinar, and they will, I think this is an open source, so they will be the pioneer for introducing this to their friends also. Well, I think this is the chance for them so that they can learn a lot from this webinar. We can't accompany all the but say all our students, but there are a few selected of them. Some we have selected them, and they are participating in this webinar.
Panchali, I have some work. So if you just allow me to a few words, then I can complete.
Yes. Monisha.
Yes.
I think madam.
Yes, can you hear me?
Madam has joined. You start.
Madam has joined. Okay.
I think.
It always gives me immense pleasure. Yes. Panchali ma'am, can I continue?
Yes, sir is waiting. That's why yes. I think, madam, you can continue.
Madam has joined, madam, I guess. Joining,
madam just told me that she is joining. I think she has joined because she phoned me 3 minutes later, before.
Okay. So I think I would also like to welcome Madam on this virtual platform. Without our beloved principal,
Ma'am Onisha, yes, you nothing can continue. Can... Madam, say me. You can continue. Okay. Okay. Sir, can yes. continue. Yes.
Thank you. Do I ask, sir, to give his speech, or Madam will give the welcome address and then sir will give his speech? Madam, can you hear me, our principal, madam? Well then, sir, I would request you to address the audience and encourage them and in a way inaugurate a week-long webinar. Sir, okay, can you okay, hear me?
So, yeah, I can hear you, and as requested, I am starting my speech now. It is always a pleasure to get associated with the colleges. You know that we are affiliating university, and the affiliated colleges are our strength. They are our pillars. At the outset, I would like to say good morning to all the participants, to the respected principal of the college, to the IQSE coordinator, Dr. Panchali Mujumdar, to Dr. Monisha, to Dr. Shubhabrata, who is joining from Bangalore and who will be the main resource person who will conduct this particular webinar and this particular course, and all others who have joined not only from this part of the country but also all over the country and from different parts of the world. I have not mistaken, and it is an international webinar that we are having. It is a week-long program. The IQSE and the Department of Physics, they need a special mention because they have taken the responsibility of organizing this particular webinar. And it is indeed a great, great thing. And it is my privilege as Vice Chancellor of the University to inaugurate with all humility. My job is to inaugurate and to say a few words without, many times without knowing the subject even. And, before lockdown, we had large numbers of seminars. Now we are having a large number of webinars. I hope that this is a good way of engaging ourselves in our academic activities. All of you know that COVID-19 has put a block to our road, and we do not know how to move. We are looking for avenues. We are looking for ways. We are looking for lanes and bylanes through which we can move and we can reach our students. So webinar is one of the ways by which we are reaching our students. Although, in my opinion, and I always say this, that although I am for online, the best thing that is possible is offline. You know, any teacher would like to face the students before him and would like to, discuss and deliberate with the students who will sit in front of the teacher. I always have done that, and I have moved around the class and spoken to the students and seen what the notes they are taking out of my lecture, and I have corrected them, have told them what they should do and this and that. Anyway, that is not possible now because of this COVID-19. All of you know the social distancing problems, the norms that have come, and we need to be extremely careful because we may have that disease. We do not know whether we have that because most of us, some of us may be asymptomatic, we do not know. So we must be careful, and we must put on mask, we must put on proper dress, we must put on gloves, and we will maintain a distance of say 6 feet so that we do not infect others. So it is not only for ourselves, it is also for others that we need to rise to this occasion and to take care of other people. So COVID-19 is teaching us also a great deal of social science, how to maintain distance. I remember long back, my experience in European countries or in United States, when my friends used to come here, they used to say that there are too many people and people always come to your space, you know. In our country, we do not like this space to be invaded. They used to say this space to be invaded. That means, you know, it is a personal space and a public space. Personal space, you know, for countries which are Western countries, for those countries, the personal space is very important. What is this personal space? It is basically around yourself. There must be some, you know, 1 meter or 2 meter distance that people will not come. People will not come very close to you. People will be a bit away, because otherwise, my friends used to say, we feel threatened. We feel threatened because, you know, someone is coming upon you. So you should not come upon you. Now, COVID-19 in our country, it is not possible because we know there are a lot many people in this country, and people are our strength. This country is 5,000 years old civilization or more than that. And this country has developed. There are many, many people in this country, and people are our strength. Although people are our strength, in this COVID-19 situation, people who are used to coming very close to the personal space now have been asked to go away from the personal space and to maintain a distance. That is basically social distancing. Now, that social distancing is something new to us, and we have to learn the procedure. Because, you know, in any situation in our society, we are used to doing certain things in a certain way. But then when the normal does not work, we have to think something of new normal. When the usual does not work, we have to think something unusual. And this webinar, although I won't say it is unusual, it is something that we are not used to. We have been more used to seminars. We have been more used to classroom teaching. But today, we are doing this webinar because we are becoming, in one way, forced. In the other way, it is the new normal that is coming, and we have to go some kind of in a hybrid system of teaching, where this webinar, this kind of classroom teaching, this kind of social distancing, everything has to be combined. So this combi form of teaching, hybrid form of teaching will come, hybrid form of research will come. There is no other way, because ultimately man's life, human life is the most important, and we must take care to save that. Now coming to this webinar, it is on open source software. Now I do not know much of open source software because I am not a person from computer science, although I know a little bit of programming because I am an engineer. And most of us have been used to working in the Windows system. Windows system is very simple. Windows system is very, but the Linux operating system and the open source system, these systems allow you the privilege to do programming in a language, in a way you want. And I have heard that this is also free from this kind of cyber crimes or cyber threat or things like that. So one needs to learn the programming language in a very, very effective way. And the gentleman who will come today, the expert who will come today, is well known because he works in the Institute of Theoretical Physics in Bangalore. And he will talk about the procedures, the methodologies through which this open source software can be utilized to solve intractable problems, the problems that we do not know to solve. So this is one way to solve problems, and also to maintain office work. You know, the way things are shaping up gradually, we are not in a position to go to office directly. We have to depend on online system. There is no other way. Because if you go to office, the office person may not come because of his problem of transport. So the point is, if that whole thing can be done, the office management software can be installed, can be created by persons who are in the college or the university, then it will be easy for all of us to to get things done in a very nice way. So that is something that the college has taken up. The college has taken this responsibility. It's a great thing that is happening. Most of the time, I find that the East Calcutta Girls College takes a lead to conduct a large number of webinars, and I will hang the principal. I'll pay my gratitude to the principal for her leadership in doing this. I will thank the IQSC coordinator, Dr. Panchali Mojumdar, for organizing these webinars. I will thank Dr. Monisha for doing the initial part, you know, the way she is conducting the whole thing. Every day, I find that things are becoming more professional. I'll request you to become more professional, because you know, this welcome speech and this inaugural speech, they may come at different times, because you know someone, you know, because your webinar time is fixed and you cannot do the way your seminar goes on. There is time overrun. That time overrun cannot be done in this webinar. So if madam is busy in something different, she may be busy, she will give her welcome speech at a time different from the inaugural speech. There is no problem at all. Only thing is, what you need to see is this. This is just my humble advice, gentle advice, is that you maintain time. That is number one. Number two is that, you know, do not feel bad if the person who will give the inaugural speech cannot come at the time you want him to come or you want her to come. Because, you know, if he comes and does this job, at some point of time, your purpose will be solved. But the most important thing is to do the teaching part, teaching the open source of software, and teaching to the students, teaching to the faculty members, teaching to different other people from different parts of the country. So that is more important, and highlight that particular thing in a very big way. That is very important. And you know, this is something like practicals are happening. This the webinar is about practicals. So now you are not only doing theoretical things in webinars, you are also doing practical things in webinar. You can also show how practicals can be done. You know, there may be a webinar where basic experiments will be done, chemistry experiments will be done by the teacher alone in the lab, and the students will see, and that way, you know, there will be some feel. Although it is known that unless you do first hand with your own hands, you will not be able to learn. It is said that, you know, you read, you forget, or you do, you remember. So basically, or you do, you understand. You see, you remember. So the point is, once you do, you understand and you remember, and the flavor of doing things is the best. But because of this COVID-19 situation, we cannot come to lab. At least, it is said in Bengali, Nai mamar theke kana mama bhalo. What is the meaning of that? If you do not have a maternal uncle, that is a situation. And if you have a maternal uncle who is blind, so the blind maternal uncle, blind uncle is better than no uncle. That is what is said. You know, it is a we call it probad. Just you know, it is usually said. So blind uncle is better than no uncle. Doing this webinar is better than doing nothing. So what is happening is that, you know, going to classroom is the best. If we can go to classroom, all our energies can be shared with the students. That is the best. But if the best cannot be done, do the good. You know, good cannot be the enemy of the best. Good cannot be the good should not be the enemy of the best. Good is also good. The best is, of course, there is no doubt about it. The best is always good. But the point is, good is also good. And this webinar is good because you are engaging students, you are engaging persons, you are engaging teachers and scholars in a platform which is not being seen. It is such a great technology. It is a technological achievement. Only problem in our country is that we do not have technology for all the people in this world, in this country, or maybe all the people in the world, that we do not have this kind of smartphone or this kind of beautiful connectivity that we are getting. We are having in Calcutta city, we are having this. Maybe, you know, far away from in a village, we may not have this connectivity. So it is a problem. point is, we must circumvent the problem. We must try to reach them. So it is basically this way we will progress. And please remember, this webinar is happening only under constraint. If there was no COVID, situation would have been normal. Because of COVID, we are forced to adopt to means which are possible. Madam has called. I do not know why madam called. Thank you very much. I am indeed grateful to all of you. I am indeed grateful to the principal. I think I have taken a little bit of time. So thank you very much.
Madam is trying to contact you so that she can't join because...
No problem at all. No problem at all. I have said very clearly. Please do not mind at all. And Panchali, please keep time. Monisha, please keep time. If inaugural speech cannot be given at the appointed hour, inaugural speech can be given at a different time. So there is no problem at all. Okay, Panchali, thank you. Okay, Monisha and Madam Dr. Shukla Hajra, thank you very much. It is my pleasure to inaugurate with all humility. You are doing the job. What am I doing? I am doing the inauguration of this seminar. It is easy for me, but for you, organizing these things and bringing all these people together, you are doing the great job. So I must, give you a pat on your back, basically, that you are doing a great job. Great job being done. Please continue doing the great job. Please talk about the constraint also. Please talk about the advantage also. Please talk about the disadvantage also. Consider everything. But anyway, doing something is always better than doing nothing. So you are engaging yourself every day in one form of the webinar or the other. You are doing a great job. You are progressing. You are moving forward. And I congratulate all of you for doing that. And it is my pleasure to inaugurate this seminar with all humility and with all regards to all of you. With best wishes from me. Stay safe. Take care. Maintain social distancing and maintain your body and spirit. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I mean, your ever encouraging words are always required, and that is why it gives us the positive feel that we are doing something which maybe will have an impact now or later. Thank you very much for encouraging us always.
Thank you.
And as you rightly pointed out, of course, there is no alternative to classroom teaching where we can share our one-to-one interaction is very important now because isolation is becoming a problem where physical distancing is now the norm. So that is something, sir, I mean, you keep reiterating and we really appreciate that you think that is very important because we also consider the same and our students also feel the same. They keep on reminding us about this problem that they are facing now when we are only meeting on this virtual platform. And yet, thank you, sir. The importance of these online classes are, of course, the need of the hour. So that is something we need to carry forward in order to engage the minds of our students and also the various academicians.
I agree entirely.
Yes, sir. Because, I mean, we need to do something substantial now at this point of lockdown. We cannot lock ourselves down completely. So even a little bit of contribution in whatever way we can, I think goes a long way to keeping the society intact and in harmony with the situation we are facing. Thank you very much, sir. We know you're very busy and yet you find time for
us. I have to attend another webinar, so I'm just taking your permission to go out.
Thank you, sir. For always sharing your moments and your guidance is very necessary for us. Thank you very much for being with us. Thank you. To please expound and explain on the theme and aim of this webinar. Do we have you with us, Dr. Panchali Mojumdar?
Yes.
Coordinator IQSC. Yes, madam. Will you please take up from here? Thank you.
Thank you, Monisha. Now, a very good morning, everybody. Unfortunately, madam can't join till now. as there is a problem in her computer and in the network also. Otherwise, every time when we are arranging all these webinars, it's the major source of energy is our respected principal madam, Dr. Shukla Hajra, who encourages us always to continue this sort of thing. And she taught us how to involve everyone so that every nook and corner we can touch. Now, today, the organizing committee gave me the opportunity to present the theme of this webinar. At first, at the very outset, regarding this webinar, you have already seen that the theme of the webinar is International Webinar on Open Source Software Hands-On Training, that is organized by Department of Physics and Internal Quality Assurance. The main essence lies in these three words, open source software. So, before I going to present my theme, I would like to say one or two words that the West Bengal State University, under which we are affiliated, under which East Calcutta Girls College is affiliated, they were the pioneer in introducing open source software. I know the subject as I am from geography. In geography in West Bengal, they were the pioneer in introducing open source software, and that was in 2015. That was quantum geography, and that was introduced by Dr. Shubhomita Chaudhuri of West Bengal State University, and the workshop was held in our college. We are proud that we have started from that day. And now, today, open source software is very popular to everyone. Because why do we focus on open source software? Because during this pandemic period, you know, the physical classroom have been shifted to digital one. Though we are not happy always, because the classroom interaction, the classroom teaching is another thing. And now we are forced to do all our classes. It's okay. With classroom teaching, we have there some digital information, digital resources, some online classes. It's okay. But now today, we have to depend totally on digital mode. And that's why the students of us don't have the access. I think sound is not coming, he is telling. Now, Jivanandu, it is okay? Is it okay, Jivanandu? Just unmute yourself and say yes. Yes?
We can hear you, madam. I think sir has some problem.
Okay.
Excuse me, Panchalidhi.
Yes.
I'll just take care of that. Why he is having that problem? Meanwhile, you please continue because you are crystal clear.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. Now, mainly the focus of this webinar is on open source because we have to access the students even at the remotest corner, and already there is a digital divide where some of the students in rural areas, they don't have the access to digital yet, till date. But we will try our best so that they can access in every respect. And the researchers particularly who have net access, they can do their research work in a proper way by using open source software. So this was the major focus of our theme, to serve everyone at free of cost. Now, The second point is that we are going to give hands-on training. As all of you know, that hands-on training through webinar is a workshop like through online mode. It's really difficult. You just saw that what is happening with us, any of us can be disconnected from this webinar at any time because of network problem, because of computer problem. But we can't make a full stop because the education, the research can't stop. So on hands-on training, we have selected some online open source resources so that you can do your research work in a more proper way. One of these is LaTeX. Through this program, we want to train ourselves with a great tool LaTeX, which is based on the WYSIWYM. That is, what you see is what you mean. The idea, meaning, you only to focus on the contents of your document and the computer will take care of the formatting. So we have to focus on our research only. And it's very easy to create professional looking material. Okay. And there is another thing. You can see it. It's a new plot is a commendable comment like program. It's a comment like program that can generate two and three dimensional plots of functions, data, and data feeds. The program runs on all major computers and operating history. It's a portable command-line driven graphing utility for Linux, MS Windows, OS X, VMS, and many other platforms. It was originally created to allow scientists and students to visualize mathematical functions and data interactively, but has grown to support many non-interactive uses such as web scripting. So this is one of the hands-on training that we will try to accommodate you during this webinar. And another is Xamarin. It's a free 2D graph plotting tool for Unix-like operating system. It runs on practically any version of Unix like OS. It has precise control of graph features, unlimited number of graphs, curves on graphs, expert PDF, support case platform like JPEG, etc. And another is Kyla. It's a free and open source cross-platform numerical computational package and a high-level numerically oriented programming language. It can be downloaded for free and can be used on any computer in a company regardless of its size. So it has a powerful environment for scientific application. So these are the more or less hands-on open source resources that we will provide you. We will try to provide you our level best so that you can accommodate with all these. Apart from that, you can see, you may think that why in physics department, when it is organized by the Department of Physics, why have you put all these things that changes in consumer sentiments in a COVID world or the things like that COVID-19 and mental health and unlocking workout regulations? Because this is necessary. We are going for success. But we are not till date able to handle our failures. So along with our learning process, we have to combat the pandemic through strengthening our mental stress, our physical fitness, so that we can stay safe at home. And we also think of our society, our people, our neighborhood, and of ourselves who may fall in any situation regarding economic crisis during this period. So we have another three sessions also on changes in consumer sentiments in a COVID world. As all of we know that COVID-19 has done something which no amount of advertisement by brands could do. It has made consumers change their preferences. preferences are newer, easy to change. They have shifted to online mode. And this pandemic changed the game faster than what brands could have ever imagined. Almost overnight, handward mall shoppers and reluctant fence sitters were pushed into depend on the online commerce pool. So we have to think of that. And now when you are opening your newspaper, you are reading your newspaper, you can see a lots of newses are there. And we are disappointed. We feel very sad for those who are no more with us. So we have to strengthen our mental health, because fighting spirit is the last word, and we can't stay backward. We have to go ahead. In this context, we have put this theme, COVID-19 and mental health, how to deal with. Yes, apart from all these learning materials, we have to fight against COVID-19. We have done this webinar. When at the first time we have done this, our principal madam taught me and all of our colleagues, our non-teaching staffs, that don't get idle in your home. Do some work so that you can feel that you are working. You are not at home, not lazily reading some books and doing and some domestic work. Yes, we have a lot of pressure. We have to do our domestic work till date, but still, we think that it's the time of mine so that I am going to my college. I'm having with my students. I'm having with my colleagues. And so all of we seated in this webinar and talking and interacting with each other so that we can strengthen our mental health. And we also put another session on unlocking workout regulations. What is unlocking workout regulations? To fit our physical health. Yes, it's essential. Unless and until we are physically fit, we can't continue this journey and combat pandemic. So we have to unlock workout regulations. We have to know all these. Thank you. I think this is the theme of the this webinar and workshop and hands-on training. I am not a person of physics, and the subjects sometimes is out of my reach. But I will try to learn from this hands-on training. I hope our respected resource persons, particularly I want to mention the name of Ninoy, who is assisting us in all these cases, all to run the webinar in a complete way. All our colleagues, our technical, all our colleagues who are giving our technical help, and to Dr. Shemanti Pal and Orpita Dash, who have done this workshop or hands-on training. They worked till midnight along with our principal madam. Both of them and principal madam were working till yesterday at midnight. I know all these things. And thanks to Monisha, who is bearing all the pain to conduct and coordinate all the webinars. Thanks a lot to all of you. Over to Monisha. Thank you.
Thank you, madam. If you say that you have no knowledge on physics, we will not believe, because you are versatile enough to very capably handle all the webinars that are going on. So we really appreciate the effort you take. And you have given us a very lucid and in-depth information regarding the theme and the aim of this international webinar. I think the participants have a very clear idea as to what to expect in the week-long international webinar. So your involvement is very clear. And of course, on this optimistic note that we have to carry on, we have to adapt ourselves and cope up with the new normal. We'll start with the technical session. But before that, I think We thank the academic cell for their unstinting help and support throughout, for their encouragement. And so we thank all the members of the academic cell for really encouraging all the participants and the members of the faculty members of East Calcutta Girls College regarding all the webinars that are being conducted. Thank you very much. I would request Dr. Shubhadeep Chakraborty, if you are there with us, sir, to please start the first technical session on LaTeX 1. Sir, am I audible to you? Dr. Shubhadeep Chakraborty? Yes, sir. Welcome, sir. So over to you, sir. Now the technical session starts. Hands-on training. I think all the participants are eagerly waiting for you to take over. Thank you very much.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, yes.
You are. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much for inviting me to lead the discussion on LaTeX. I will thank all the organizers now. I will start. So I should cross this one. So I will stop the video to save data and I will share my screen. Please tell me if you don't see my screen. Okay, so I am stopping video. So it is host disabled the participant screen sharing. So could you please do that?
Hello?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, Shubhadeep, can you please check now? I have enabled it.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I could do that.
I'm sorry for the inconvenience.
No, it's fine. So,
yes, it's visible.
Yeah, can you see? Yeah, okay, thank you. So I'm in this mode. So let me start. Talking about writing document LaTeX. So you know that LaTeX is a free software. So my previous speakers has told about what is free software, and you already know about what is free software movements and something. So LaTeX is made a mathematician, group of mathematicians to write some documents, letters, etc. So the second line is slightly demotivating, but is actually motivating. So it is difficult to learn, but very easy to execute once you learn it. Okay. So there are some advantages and disadvantages of LaTeX. I'm not going to compare with other writing softwares like Windows or anything. I mean, Word, Microsoft Word. So the first advantage is obviously it is free of cost. Okay. And the next advantage you will see when I go through the slides, but let me say briefly that you don't need to worry about position and number of figures, equation, table, etc. Okay. So LaTeX will take care of that and rearrange them according to the software and document class, you will see. And you also don't need to worry about if you rearrange your document at the end. So sometimes, say you have submitted your paper in some journal, okay? And then you change the journal. So everything will change, right? The arrangement or everything will change according to your journal. So you don't need to worry about, you just change the document class and LaTeX will take care of that. So we'll discuss about the basic things here and provide that study material for advanced things at the end of the course. And you see and notice that I have written everything in details in the slide. Okay, so that if you cannot hear me, you can read it. Is it fine? And also there is comment box. If you, I will give time after some duration, you can comment what is your problem or not, and you can also comment if you cannot hear clearly or anything else. First, we will operate accordingly, and she will tell me what is the problem and how to solve that regarding June meeting. Okay, so we will go slow so that everyone can understand. And I have already provided these slides in the Google Classroom. So please do not waste your time to copy everything in your notebook. And in the screen as big as possible, or you can use a separate screen for the Zoom meeting in your mobile. And please use your computer or laptop to practice with me during this talk. Okay? So you can practice now. So here is the outline of my this course. So I will start by some basic structure of LaTeX document. Then I will discuss about font, abstract, paragraph, sections, etc. Then I will go to mathematical typesetting, which is the most important part in LaTeX. And I will show how to include figures and tables in the in a document using LaTeX, and how to cite a paper. And at the end, it is, you know, this is only three class, so it is not possible to explain everything in this short time. So I will provide some advanced document, and what I will briefly discuss what else could be done using LaTeX. Okay, so here are some preliminary instruction you can follow. So create a blank file. First create a blank folder, press new folder. Okay, name it practice or something, and create a blank file ended with .txt. This will be, LaTeX software can read this txt file, tx file, sorry. As for example, semanti.txt. And
Yes, sure. May I share my screen and show them how to create a blank folder and a blank text file?
Yeah, sure, you can show them.
In Windows.
And yes.
I'll just keep myself muted, and I'll just, you can just give the instructions. I'll just show how to create the blank folder and the blank file, and you can show it in the Linux system.
Okay, no problem. Okay, please share it.
Can you please stop your screen share?
Yeah, I stop. Okay.
Is it visible?
Yeah, it is visible.
So I'll just create a new folder here. This folder, I'll rename it as LaTeX test, whatever. And I'll just open it, right click on it, and new, and then text document, right?
Yeah, any text document.
Okay, so let's give it a name, text.txt.
E-X.
C-E-X.
E-X.
Yeah. And I need to confirm the extension change. And if I say EX, then it will show either the Text Studio icon or the Text Maker icon.
Yeah.
So and now I'll just stop sharing and
I'm
really sorry for interrupting you. So I'll just stop sharing and you can now just continue.
So how to do that? Can you see my slides? I don't think so.
No, you need to share the screen again.
Oh, yes. Okay. Share screen. This one. Okay. So you learned how to create a folder and a file in Windows. You can do in similar way for Ubuntu also. I mean, any Linux operating system. So I will do that when I will go for that. Right now, okay. Let me just screen. How can I remove this part? I don't know. Okay. So create a .txt file, then open it by your respective LaTeX software. Don't do that now. I will tell you when to do. And such as TechStudio or Kyle or Technic or anything. And a window will appear. Type what is being said in the next few slides. Note that you need to click on the PDF LaTeX symbol to compile. I will show where is the symbol of the tech file, and it will create a PDF file according to your name of the tech file. If you give name Semonti.tech, it will create Semonti.pdf. Okay. So here is a view of a typical LaTeX editor. It is TechStudio, and Kyle or TechMaker will also show you similar image. Okay. So can you see my cursor? I am moving my cursor. Can you see it?
Yes.
Okay, fine. So in this region, you will write what I will say or what you want to type in this region. And there are many suggestions here. I will come to it later. And once you typed, you can run or compile using this double green button, and it will create the PDF file. Okay, or for different editor, you can use the quick build or PDF LaTeX option visible in the window. And if you get some error, okay, yeah, that error part will be visible here during the compilation or running. The error part will be visible in this region. Okay, so as the very basic structure of a LaTeX document is following. So the first line must be document class. Okay, so every command in a LaTeX document will start by a backslash. Okay, so backslash document class, this is a command, the very beginning command, and after that article will give you the information, not you, give the compiler the information, which type of document is this. There are many types. You can see the article, you can write beamer inside second bracket. Then it will give you the slides of the presentation. You are seeing, I made this presentation in LaTeX. So I use document class beamer. Okay, if you want to write article. And if you want to write a book, you can write book. And if you wanted to write a letter, you should type a letter here. Okay, so this is the document class. So the LaTeX compiler will know what kind of document is to process, as there are very different style rules and different kinds of documents available. Okay, so we will use RevTech4 document class exclusively in this course. This is a special document class for writing papers in physical review journal. So we will use this one. So document class, no space in between, no blank space in between, backslash document class, then a second bracket, and inside second bracket, you should write RevTech4. Okay. So this is the document class we are going to use, and other possible class I have discussed. So after that, you need to write begin document. So this is the signal to the compiler that now you are going to start begin document. If you write begin document, you have to write end document. It is compulsory. If you begin something, you have to end. And you can write whatever you want in between begin document and end document. Okay. So the three basic lines of a typical LaTeX document is document class, then begin document, and then end document. Okay, so I'm going to the next slide. So I'm continuing that part. So optional information in document class command is included in square bracket. For example, this one. So document class RevTech4, this is essential. RevTech4 is essential. So it is within second bracket. Okay. And the optional things, if you don't put anything in the third bracket, then it will run. But if you want to specify something, suppose PRD, this is a particular journal, physical review E, and you want one column document, not two column document. So you write two here, you need to write here one column. And if you want to make the point size or font size in your document 12, then you need to write 12 PT, PT for point. Okay, all are optional inside the third bracket. But this is essential, the RevTech 4. Okay, so any command before begin document will affect the whole document. So any command like PRD, one column or two column, okay, 12 point or 10 point, they will affect the whole document. And the body of the document where you include all your text must are between begin document and end document commands. Clear? So any text that comes after end document command will be ignored by the compiler. So it will not read or compile anything you write after end document. So let us check our software. So write down the following things in your LaTeX window. So open your window. I also open it for me. So split your screens or use some other device. So you are gonna do this with me. So don't miss anything else, it will give an error. Okay, so just type this part. Sorry. This part from this line to this line, you just copy, you take a document, and then we compile using the editor. So I am going to the editor, and I will write. Can you? Any question till now?
Shubhadeep, the voice broke at the last section. Could you please repeat?
Hello?
Shubhadeep, the voice broke at the last part. So can you please repeat?
Oh, I have to repeat? Okay, no problem. Yeah. Okay, okay. Sorry for the inconvenience. Oh, which part?
The last part. The last part.
This part or this part?
Yeah.
So this is also the I am discussing about the basic structure. Very basic structure of a LaTeX document. So everything inside the second bracket is essential information, but if you need some optional information like journal type, one column or two column, or font size of your document, you can put them within the third bracket. Okay, and anything you write before begin document will affect the whole document. Okay, so this is the PRE is a particular journal, physical review E. So I wrote this. This is optional, you can write or not. And one column, you know, this one column or two column document. And PT is for point size. So 12 PT will give you font size 12. You can change it to 10, 11, whatever you want. And the body of the document, where you include all your text, must occur between begin document and end document commands. Okay. And any text coming after end document command will be ignored by the compiler. It will not read or compile after end document. Okay. So let us check our software. So we are going to check our software by typing from this line to this line. Okay. And we'll create a PDF by clicking on the PDF LaTeX. We will see. So I am going to I stop sharing this. I have already shared my slides with you in the classroom, right? I hope you have downloaded it. If not, please download it. and see that slide and type this, or you can copy from there directly. Okay, so I'm going. I am stopping sharing slides and going to the compiler. Okay. So. Oh, sorry. Desktop. Share. Okay, so I will create a folder here. For Ubuntu people, you can create using your terminal also. I hope you know that. So I am creating a folder here. Okay. So let's name it practice. Okay. So I will create by right clicking a blank document, new document, empty document, and rename it with say test0.tex. This is the LaTeX file. Okay. So I will open it. Open it with my editor. Okay. Other applications. It is not. I can open it by get it. Okay, no problem. So now I will write whatever written in the slide. So the first line is obviously document class. So type with me document class. So if you face any problem, you just type in the comment box and the host will interact with me. Okay. Document class. So it changed color. So it is more or less correct. Document class. Then I will give a document class name, which is RevTEX4. Okay. Now this is essential, but I want some optional things, which is PRE, comma, then one column, column, then, and I also want point size, say 12 pt. Okay. So in the next line, so I will write begin document, B-E-G-I-N, begin, within second bracket, D-O-C-U-M-E-N-T, document. Okay, and I will end the document also, D-O-C-U-M-E-N-T. Okay, now what you can write whatever. So hello, this is my first writing in LaTeX. Okay, so I'm going to save this by typing Control S. You not need to save this. So another thing I will do. Now I will open it with Kyle. Okay, the Kyle is the LaTeX editor I have installed. You can open it with your own editor. So you can see here. So document class PRE one column 12 point RevTeX 4 begin document everything. Now, okay, how can I? Yeah. So now I will use this symbol, PDF LaTeX. You can use double green symbol in your Tech Studio compiler. So I will click on this and you can see some change occurs here. So it is typing done, means no error, everything is good. So it has created. So I will click here again to be sure. So it is done. Zero error, zero warning. So it has, you can see, you can go to that folder. The test0.pdf has been created. Okay, if you open it, we'll see. Hello, this is my first writing in LaTeX. Okay, with a page number. This one is the page number. It will take automatically. I hope you all have done this. I will give you one more minute. This is very simple. And if you face any problem, please share in the chat box. I'm going to the chat box. Okay, right. It is. I should. I'm stopping sharing so I can see the chat box. So I am waiting. Should I share it again? The screen. So what is the problem? I don't know. Moha Parmakar Windows. Is there anyone who could not do it?
Madam Karmakar, Madam Moha Karmakar, you are please requested to unmute yourself and please state the problem. Madam Moha Karmakar.
Yes. Yes. I think it was in a Linux platform. How to do it in the Windows?
Yes, but you have that compiler, right? You have installed it, right?
Yes, I have installed what was asked to do. It is opening, LaTeX is opening, and the Windows is there. And this I have typed in the new file, and now I have to compile it.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now, which is the compilation symbol?
Should I share my screen and you can explain? Hello, Shubhadeep, are you there?
Yeah. Madam is there? Moha, madam?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I'm here. Yeah.
Yeah, please share.
So, Moha, madam, do you have Text Studio or Text Maker? What do you have?
Text Studio.
Text Studio. Then, when the window opens, it comes like something like this.
Yes.
So can you see this double green button?
And double green, yes.
Yes. So if you just click on it, and then it will compile and it will get you the PDF view. This is for compilation and view.
Some error.
Yeah. Madam, do you have any desk or team viewer?
No. I don't have. I just communicated it before this session. It will take time. The computer is not free now. Download all these things.
Please tell Shubhadeep.
It is showing error. Which kind of error?
Yes, error line to file RefTeX DS not found.
Okay, so one thing you can do, you just you have the slides in PDF format, right? I have shared in classroom. Do you have?
No, I have not opened till now.
Okay. I think you have typed wrongly. Give some extra space.
Maybe. Okay.
Yeah. Spelling mistake is there, I think. Document class or anything.
Can you be able to share your screen? Then the speaker can.
Yeah, you can share your screen here.
Actually, my computer is not connected. I am joining this Zoom platform in my smartphone, and I have opened simultaneously my laptop also separately. How to do? Then.
Okay. You switch on your video.
Okay.
Then you show my your screen.
Moho madam, are you there? Is it showing? No, yeah. Moho madam, are you there?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes?
I can see something.
Moho madam, please get the AnyDesk or TeamViewer installed. So then I can do it remotely. And please listen to the lecture in the meantime. The recordings will be provided.
Okay.
So we will just proceed if other people have done it already.
Okay.
In the meantime, you please get these things installed and I'll just start from the...
Okay.
Yeah, you can, contact me personally after that.
Okay, fine.
Please switch off your video and I am sharing my screen again. So let me do this extra. Hello, can you see? Mm-hmm. I think, yeah?
Yes.
Okay. So you have successfully done, most of you, I hope. The first part of the writing documents. So, say additional structure of a LaTeX document. So, the page numbering and heading, you can set this using the command slash. Any command will start with a slash. So, backslash, then page style. Okay, this command controls the page numbering and heading. So, it should be it should always go between document class, whatever document class it is, and the begin document command. So it will come in between document class and begin document command. And there are different type of page style. So if you, the number one is page style plain. So this is default. If you don't write anything about page style, it will take this page style plain. And this puts the page number at the center of the bottom. So in here, so at the bottom of the page and at the center and provides no heading. So heading means so in the corner you can see the section name if you have heading. So the next page style is empty. So it provides nothing, neither page number or heading. And the third page style is heading. Okay, so slash page style headings. It will provide page numbers and headings from any section from that page, okay, that you are using. So you will see an example later. So just remember that. Okay, now creating a title. Okay, so following this should go after begin document commands. Okay, so after begin document, you should write, you don't need to put this 1, 2, 3 numbers. Just write title, slash title, then your title of the document, and slash author, then your name, slash affiliation, so your institute name, and then slash date. Everything is optional, you can write or not. And this slash affiliation will work for this particular document class I'm discussing, say RevTech 4, it may not work for other class. Okay, so the title and author are universal, they will work everywhere, and date also. Okay, so you need to write these 4 things, which are optional, but yeah, essential to write a document. So optional in the sense that you can run your LaTeX document without these things, but you need to write them. So given that you have provided this information, you may or may not want a title heading. Okay, so if you want a title heading, place a make title command slash make title command immediately after these commands. Okay, I will show you. So here is a sample. So you can edit your text file don't miss anything, and you have already written this document class, then just type page style plain. As it is plain, so you may not write anything. So just write page style plain. Then begin document is there. So edit your document. Just writing after begin document, these four lines. Title is writing documents in LaTeX. So LaTeX itself is a command here. So it will give you the logo of the LaTeX. You can type in ordinary style. And /author, write your name here. And then affiliation, write your institute name and date, the current date. And then write make title. If you don't write this, although you have written these things, it will not show you title. So /make title will make the title page. Okay. Then write, it is already written in your document. So after that, in document, we'll finish the document. Okay. Now I'll stop sharing. Go to the compiler or editor and do the same thing. Okay, so this type these things in your TeX document and compile it to get the PDF. So I am going to the TeX document. So can I? Yeah, I can copy from here. Okay, so I am going to copy. Everything from here I have copied and I will paste in my editor. Okay, I will select and replace. So I have replaced. I have replaced whatever written in that slide. So you can see the first line, obviously. You can put enter here to make it clear. That is not harmful. Okay. So here is my TeX document. So it is as it was previously, PRE column 12 point. Then page title will come, page style will come. And then title, author, affiliation and date. And then what you want to write here. So this line will remain same. So hello, this is my first writing in LaTeX. Okay, so this is also a command, LaTeX. Okay, it will give you the logo of LaTeX in the PDF. So let us compile it. Please let me know in the chat box if you have any problem. So I am compiling using this PDF LaTeX. You can do with the green button, double green button. So it is done. It is written here, no error, it is done. So let me check. Yeah, here it is. So you can see the title appeared in large font automatically, writing documents in LaTeX. After that, my name, my institute, the date in this format, and then the what I have written in the document. Okay, so I will give one more minute to do this. I will check the box. I'll stop sharing. I'll check the chat box. So please let me know if someone cannot do. I am waiting. I think everybody can do it. It is very easy. Not done? Okay. Any problem?
Shubhadev, hello.
Yeah.
I actually, I guess Dr. Khatun has some problem with her installation file.
So
I have just asked her to download AnyDesk and provide me with the ID. So I'll just check it separately. In the meantime, you can address the other issues.
Okay, fine. Someone is asking me to share the screen what I have written. So I am sharing again. Okay. So after that, I will go to the next slide. So can you see? Yeah, a larger font. Is it visible now?
Participants are kindly requested to respond in the chat box to the speaker. Otherwise, he will not be able to understand whether you are able to see it or not. So I can see the screen perfectly clear, and okay. Your voice is seen too.
Okay, I hope this is done. You can directly copy from the PDF I have shared. Okay, so I am going to the next slide now. So you can try removing the make title command. It will not show you the title, nothing else will happen. Okay, so use of packages. So there are lots of packages already people have made to take care of special characters like alpha, beta, mathematical symbols like this double arrow, single arrow, not equal to sign. Everything has been included in the packages. They will take care of them. So if you want to include packages in your document, you should write it after begin document command. Okay, sorry, not after. So in between the document class and begin document command, in between. So before the begin document. So here are some. Sorry. So here are some packages I have shared with you. The slide you can copy from there. So use these packages, or you can take time, not now. So copy them and put them in your tech file. So always keep a copy of your previous tech file, right? So otherwise, if you find some error, you cannot go to the previous one. So keep a copy of your previous file and edit in of the copied version. Okay, so copy this. The comments in your tech file now, and try to compile. So if some error come, then which indicates that either you don't have, you need to install, or you have typed wrongly. So you don't need to install now; it will take time. So just if you show some error after. Using these packages, so please do delete these packages. Okay, this is not essential, but you can keep them. Okay, so I am going to the. So I will copy this thing. Okay, I have copied it, and I will put them in my Kyle file. So I will keep as I suggested you. So I will copy and paste and rename. Okay, so test 0, make it test 1. Okay, test 1. Now open it, right click, open with your Kyle. So yeah, test one is open, you can see. Now I will copy these packages I have copied. and then I will put them in my new file, test one. So in between, just after the document class, in between document class and begin. So I have put all the packages. So I will check whether they are giving anything wrong, any error or not. So I clicked on the PDF LaTeX and it is going done. Right? So they are pre-installed in my computer. I hope you also have. So if you do find some error after giving these packages, so delete one by one and check whether they are installed or not. I mean, you must need this package, first one. Use package, the first one, AMSNet. And the rest are, I think, optional right now. Okay. So, I hope you have done this copying thing. Now I will go to the slide again. Please let me know in the comment box if you face anything. Okay. So writing an abstract. So how to write an abstract? You need to write abstract in an abstract environment. Okay, that is in between. So you need to write begin abstract and end abstract. And you need to, whatever you write in between this begin abstract and end abstract, it will appear as an abstract in a smaller font and that particular format of abstract. You will see later when you will use it. So anything you want as abstract, you should write in between begin abstract and end abstract comments. Okay. So the abstract should come immediately after or before make title comment, depending on the document class. So for say article, if your document class is article, then you need to write after the make title comment. Okay, this is the abstract, but here we are using document class RevTeX 4. So we will write abstract after the make title comment. Okay, so we'll write abstract after make title comment. So we'll write abstract before make title comment. Okay, so let me go to the next slide. So font size. You have already written this optional font size in the document class within the third bracket, right? So it will affect the whole document. But what if you want to change some text, some particular text in your document, the font size of your text? So there are many comments for this. Here is a title. Do ignore the this right hand side. Just look at the comments. So slash tiny. Tiny will give the smallest font size. Then script size, footnote size will appear. So if you do this, use these comments, it will change your font size of the selected part, not all over. You need to select some part. You want to change font, okay? So small, normal, large. The maximum is huge with a capital H and the smallest one is tiny, okay? So how does it look? So if you write the word physics using this command, it will look like this. The output will be like this. So you need to put second bracket before tiny and after the text. So before tiny, second bracket starts and it ends after the particular region you want to make tiny. Okay. So for different text size, you will get different. So this tiny is very tiny and huge is very huge. Okay. So the physics term, the word will appear like this using the font size. We will do it at exercise later. Okay. So, see, there are many other options to change the text type. So, first one is the bold font. Okay. So, BF stands for bold font. So, / BF physics will give you bold physics. Again, the way to write is in that just starting before BF, you just put an second bracket and you end it after the word. Okay. For italic, it is IT. Now, for underline, it is different from these two because you have to write first underline, then you need to put the selected word or words inside the second bracket. So it will make the physics underline. Okay. So this is the output. And you can change the color of your text and the ways. So / text color. I mean, you can see the commands are very easy because it is self-explanatory, right? So this is bold font, BF, italic, IT, this text color. Okay, then red. Okay, you need to write exactly in this way. So / text color, then which color you want to use, this is red. Then which type, which word or text you want to make red, this is physics. So it will give an output, physics in red color. Okay, so if you write physics and some two words, physics and chemistry, with lots of space, it will give only the output will be with only one space. So one blank space is same as million blank space. It doesn't matter. Okay, so if you write one blank more than one blank space, it will consider an as one blank space. So tabs are treated like blank space, and blanks at the end of the line are ignored. So if you put many blank space after the line, it will be ignored by the compiler. A single enter, okay, enter means the enter key. So if you press enter key once, or a single enter is treated like a blank space. Okay, so it will not break the line. It will break the line in your LaTeX document with a single enter, but when you compile it, it will treat at a single line because the enter will be treated as a blank space. And more than one enter marks the beginning of a new paragraph. So if you want to start a new paragraph, you need to put the enter twice, not in the LaTeX document. Okay, so the loops in the LaTeX document and PDM is different. So if you put one enter in LaTeX document, it will be then it will be treated as a new paragraph in your PDF. But if you need more space between two words, okay, then you need to put this wiggle sign between two words or anywhere. Okay, so if you put these wiggle signs, it will be translated by the compiler as blank space in the PDF. Okay, you can see there are lots of space in between physics and chemistry due to this wiggle sign. I hope this is clear. So after this slide, we will go to the assignment one and we will try this here. I will do with you. Okay. So hyphenation and quotation. So there are three types of or four types of hyphens in LaTeX. So if you put just one hyphen, hyphen means you know, in your keyboard with your minus sign. Okay. So a single dash, not the minus sign. This is single dash hyphen. So this will be just ordinary hyphen in your PDF. If you put two dashes simultaneously, so it will give a range of numbers. You can see in the examples. And if you put three dashes, it will be the honest to goodness dash. Okay, you will see in the example. And if you put dash in between two dollar sign, a minus sign will appear as a math mode. This dollar sign is called math mode. We will discuss about it later in details. Okay. So here are some examples. So you need to type these three things in the tech file, and the output in the PDF will be this. So the first line, you can see my cousin-in-law, you put single dash, it will appear as single dash in the output. But here, I lived in Germany in 1995 to 6. So you put here two simultaneous dash. So it will be translated as a large hyphen, okay? And the second example is, he speaks French. Really, he does. I mean, you are assuring, okay? So honest. So he speaks French, the three dash will be a long dash. Really, he does. And his favorite number is minus two. You can see within dollar sign, minus two will appear as minus two. This is just an ordinary dash in the tech file, but it will appear as minus in the PDF after compilation. And how to use a quotation. So in a quotation, there are left quotation and right quotation, right? So to begin a quotation in Word or Microsoft Word, we put just the inverted comma twice. The same inverted comma in the beginning and at the end. But here in the beginning, you need to write this sign. This is at left top of the keyboard, just before the key with one. You can see below the wiggle sign. So you need to use this to start a quotation and ordinary inverted comma to end a quotation. Okay. So if you want single quotation, you will use this once and then single ordinary inverted comma, single inverted comma instead of this at the end. So it will be translated as quotation in your PDF, right? So it's time to practice. So please type this thing. I have already said in the classroom in the PDF. So type this thing, or I have uploaded that PDF in the assignment as assignment one. You can see this, the same thing. Okay. So you need to practice this. There are underlines, change of color, bold font, italic font, everything is there. Okay. So I am going to type this with you. So any comment? Any clear anything need out? So should I stop sharing now? Oh no. There are lots of conversations. Hello, Simantidi, are you on?
Yeah, yes, Shubhadev, please tell.
So I see lots of comments in the chat box.
Yes.
So...
Yes, you can address the comments related to the related to your tutorial. So it's like someone asked how to write text in secondary colors.
How to write secondary color? Which comment?
it's from Miss Ruchika Gupta.
Ruchika Gupta, yes.
You can scroll downwards.
Text in secondary, like purple. Okay, then for color you need to use, you need to install some different packages to get many colors. But the four basic colors are there, green, blue, red. I mean, you need to replace red by blue. You will get blue color. Okay. In the slide, I have shown where to put red. Okay. / text color, then red. So you just replace red by blue. You will get blue. You can replace with green also. Okay. And to get purple or many other colors, you need to search. I don't know. So, and Orko Prabhagupto, that KSN is not working in my compiler. Okay, they just comment it out. Just delete the line affiliation. And it's showing error with the use package AMS math. Okay, then it is not installed in your machine. You need to install it or download it. We will take time and you see later. So just whatever it is coming, you just remove that part. Remove affiliation, remove use package AMS math. Okay. So we should go to again to the, I think any other question. I got something in a private message which is kindly explain function of each package. Okay, that will take time. You can copy the package name and Google it. Okay, I mean, each package, that is not, I mean, very essential in this hot time. They have some function, just believe me. Anything else? How to install this particular package? If you install the TakeLive full, not the TakeLive basic or TakeLive, recommended, there are many TakeLive. If you install the TakeLive full, it will automatically take all the packages. And you can Google it how to use that package. If you don't find, I will tell you later how to install this package. And if you face any problem without this package right now, I don't think so you will face. But if you face, let me know. Okay. So I am going to share my screen again. Okay, to show how to write that things, the assignment one. So how much time I have? 20 minutes. Yeah, I think I will be done with the assignment one. Okay. So assignment one is here. What could this thing? Okay. So I need to write this. You have already this and this part. Up to this, you have written. Okay. Now you need to write this part. Okay, so what I'm going to do, you just see and type, okay, or you can copy from the PDF. But it will give error, it is not a good idea right now to copy. You just type something. You don't need to do everything. You do the assignment at your home, but you just write just few words, okay. And I will show you how to do these things. So, yeah, here. Okay. So, it is already open. Okay. Now, I will replace this hello part by some text. Okay, so I am using the same take file. You can keep a copy before doing it. So, yeah, why not copying the whole thing? Let me copy the whole thing. Yeah. So you can see. So I will edit this. So first place is put somewhere. I mean, I want this notation guide part. I want to make italic. Okay. So I don't need to do separately. Sorry, no space. Yeah, the backslash will be there, and then space. Okay. So this command will make these two words notation guide as italic. Let me check. So I am doing PDF LaTeX, and I'll check the test1.pdf. Yeah, you can see the notation guide is in italic format. Okay, now go to your editor again. You want to make some part, say this part, or sorry, this physical review style part. You want it bold. So slash bold font slash BF, then a space. Okay, it will make this part bold. So I have compiled it, and I will check. Yeah, it is bold, right? I'll go again. So I want to make some part underline. Say this is essential, that this part I want to make underline. Okay, so first put two second brackets, then write slash underline underline. Okay, yeah, the compiler is smart enough, he is suggesting me. I don't click on it because I have already written. So underline this part. Okay, so PDF LaTeX. Yeah, essential that the notation. Okay, again I will do two things together. First is make quotation. Okay, I mean so I want to make this word standardized within a quotation. So I use this key. Sorry. Twice, and then ordinary inverted comma here. Double inverted comma. And then do PDF. Okay, I will check it later because it is taking time. Then I will make this part say red. Okay, or reference manual. This part I want to put as red. So select this part. Before that, type slash text text colo. R text color, then the color you want. I want blue, BLUE, blue. Okay, sorry, no, it's fine. So I will compile it and check. No error here, so I will check the PDF. Yeah, it is blue. inverted comma is also here, standardized. Okay. So, yeah, next thing is to write a paragraph. One enter and two enter. Sorry. So, you can see everything written here with one enter. So, suppose, yeah, so everything, so if I put a enter here, after this word, this, okay? So this guide, okay? So I want to make one enter here. So it will not make anything, any change, because it will consider it as a space. So if you PDF LaTeX, it will change nothing. But if you give another enter here, so one enter here and another enter here, you can see it will make a paragraph. Okay. So I am compiling and then check the PDF. Yeah. This is another paragraph with a indentation. You know what is indentation in paragraph? You leave some space before this. Yeah, it is a starting of a paragraph. So it will automatically leave some space. This is called indentation. But sometimes you don't need indentation. Suppose for some equation you have interrupted your paragraph. So after the equation you want to continue that paragraph. So you don't need any space before that paragraph. So you need to write, sorry. So you need to write, give another enter, and write slash no indent. Okay. So click anywhere. Yeah. So no indent. It will start another paragraph without any indentation or any space in the beginning. Okay, so I am compiling it and let me check. Yeah, so it is a new paragraph but without any indentation. See, there is an indentation here but no indentation here, no space before the paragraph. Okay, so you can do the rest in the assignment one yourself, or if was something wrong, we will discuss tomorrow. Nothing else. I am stopping sharing the screen. Please let me know in the comment. Okay, fine. I hope you all have done this. So I am going to share my screen again. How to install package. Right now, I will tell you later. Okay, so I will send a common mail to everyone. Which one? This one? How to change font of only a certain portion of the text, not the whole document. Yeah, to do that, okay, I'm saying it. Font means font type, font size, anything, right? Font size, okay. So, yeah. So, suppose you want to make these contributors large. Okay, so just select it with second bracket. So put a second bracket here and then type slash large, L-A-R, there are different kind of large command. So capital L is one of them, capital L-A-R-G-E, then space. Okay, So it will make the world contributors large. And if you want more contributor and section both to make large, you need to put the second bracket here. Okay, it will make large. So let us check PDF LaTeX. Yeah, it is large. Contributors section.
Both bold and large.
Okay. If you want both bold and large, you need to put it bold slash BF, sorry, not slash BF for bold function. Then end the second bracket for bold function. Okay, so it will make this bold function command will make it bold and the large will make it large. Let us try PDF LaTeX. Yeah, bold and large, and see the beauty of LaTeX. It make a hyphen here, section, to adjust the width of the text, I mean the document. I didn't put anything. It will do it automatically. And that is why people use LaTeX. Okay. So I am going to the next slide. I hope it is clear. Or I will see comment. Okay, I am stopping sharing. I will see the comments again. Oh, say Times New Roman or anything. Okay, you can first of all you need to, you can do it for the whole document, declaring it in the beginning of the document, or you can do it partly also. You need to find. Okay, I will tell you later. I will find it, the actual command to do this font type, Times New Roman or anything. Yeah, there must be something, right? This, yeah, Times New Roman or anything. Okay. Okay, I think we are done with this assignment. You will do the rest yourself. Text color is not showing. I think the color package you need to install. I have installed this color package, right? Some package color. Use package color. I think so. I don't know. I'm not sure. I think so. Okay, text color is, not essential right now. Just because this is a short talk. So anything you face problem, you just keep that and try to learn the next things. So I am going to share my screen again. So, yeah, where is the presentation? Presentation, this one, yeah. So sections and subsection, okay? You need this to write a document. A very essential thing. So there are two related commands for creating sections. One is slash section, then the section title, and another is slash section star with same section title. The only difference is the star. Okay, the first one will give a number, section number. Okay, while the second one doesn't. Okay, let me show one PDF. You can see, not here. Okay. Assignment one, assignment. Okay, let's see this one. This is a PDF. So you can see, so this is the section name, principal heading, and this is section number. Okay. Okay. So this is subsection heading. And this is subsection number, this A. A is subsection number. And this is sub-subsection. This will appear under subsection. This sub-subsection heading. And this is sub-subsection number. So if you put star, then this number will not appear. You will see only the section or subsection title, not the numbers. Okay? And if you don't put star, it will give you the number, which will be useful in future if you want to refer some section. Suppose in section A, I have discussed about this. So then this A number is essential, right? So I would suggest the slash section, the ordinary. So I will recommend this slash section, then section style. Okay, so it will give you so it will create separate sections with titles in a larger font size, and they also provide information to LaTeX in case you want to create a table of contents. So if you want to create a table of contents, so it will be very easy if you give section numbers. Okay. So it will be done automatically just by a single command. We will see later to create a table of content using these sections. And the subsection command is similar. So just replace the section with subsection. Okay. Slash subsection, then subsection title. And if you don't want subsection number, just put a star here. Subsection star. Okay, the sections and subsection can be referred by their numbers anywhere in the text. Okay, now try it. Try to put sections and subsections. So I have put assignment 2. Okay, and I am showing you the. Okay, after the, I will take a break. Samudhi, are you on?
Yes, Shubhadeep, I guess we should take a break now.
Yeah, so in the meantime, how much? 15 minute break, right?
We will take a 30 minute break. Then 30 minute? 1:30 again. Or maybe 1:20. Whatever is convenient.
Okay, I have a 15 minute break is fine with me. Is it fine with everyone? I mean, what you have told?
Okay, so. I have asked for a 15 minutes break. So if it's okay with you, then we can start again at 1:15.
1:15 we will start again. Okay. In the meantime, so you just I will open the assignment 2. Have a look. I have uploaded it in the classroom. You please download it and try to create just before this equation part. Okay, the last part is the equation part. Don't write this. You cannot do this. So up to this, you can write. Okay. So sections and subsections. You please do using the section and subsection commands. In the meantime, you within this 15 minutes, and we'll come again later. At 1:15, right?
All right.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Shubhadeep. Thanks a ton for your lecture, and it was very informative. So, my request is to all the participants that we will be back again at 1:15. So, let's get refreshed yourselves. See you at 1:15. Thank you.
So there is a question. Okay, I will discuss it later after 1:15. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So I am leaving this conversation now. I will join at 1:15.
Sure.
Okay.
Thanks again.
Hello, Shemanti. Hello, Shemanti, can you hear me? Hello, Shemanti, there is no sound.
Hi, Pankalidhi, please tell. Shubhati, Kakshi. Pankalidhi, hello.
Yes. Yes,
Panchalita, we have taken a break of 15 minutes. So, Dr. Shubhadip Chakrabarty has left the session and we will be back at 1:15.
Okay.
Thank you.